Hello, grade 10 students. In this particular lecture series, we are going to revise all 9 chapters of geography. And today we'll start with the first chapter, that is field visit. And I assure you that, you know, after watching this video, you don't have to read textbook at all. So let us have the quick revision of this particular chapter, that is field visit. In this particular chapter, जैसे आप देखोगे कि काफी सारे वन लाइनर्स हैं जो आपको अच्छे से करने होंगे, बट बिफोर दैट वी विल ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड सम इम्पोर्टेंट पॉइंट्स फ्रॉम दिस चैप्टर. ओके, तो अगर आप ये चैप्टर में देखोगे तो देर आर थ्री फोर्स दे हैव मेंशन. सो द फर्स्ट फोर्ट वी विल टॉक अबाउट इज नलदुर्ग फोर्ट. सो देर आर पॉइंट्स अबाउट इट. फर्स्ट थिंग, इट इज लोकेटेड इन उस्मानाबाद डिस्ट्रिक्ट. यस, करेक्ट. Second point is, it is located on plain land. We know that there is a waterfall called as Narmadi waterfall at this particular fort. Now these are all important points regarding the Nalduriga fort. Then there comes the second fort, which is Sinhagarh fort. Iska location aap dekhoge to, it is located in Pune. Very important point. Second point is, in this particular region, you will find that if you just climb this particular fort, you will find one dam, that is Khadakwasla Dam. It is on river Mutha. And then if you come to the last one, that is Alibag Fort, which is located in Raigarh. We know that this particular fort is located on a wave cut platform. There is another name of this fort called as Kolaba Fort. And you know that there are so many forts which are which were constructed during medieval time for the securities of the seas. So this fort was also constructed for the same purpose. So these all three forts are important, and there can be a question on any one of this. Nalduriga Fort, Sinhagarh Fort and Alibag Fort. Now we talk about the location that we have seen in this particular chapter. We'll start with the first one, where our field visit journey starts, and that is Usmanabad Fort. That is Usmanabad. Now why this particular region is important, try to understand. First thing, here we find that the rainfall is less, and that's why we have deciduous type of vegetation. Now what do you understand by deciduous types of vegetation? Here the rainfall is between 1000 to 2000 millimeter. Teak is one of the important tree that is found in this region. Even we find in some regions shrub type of vegetation also. The important crops which are grown in this region are pulses. In chapter, if you see, there are two pulses that I have mentioned, moor, udad. And one thing that we need to understand, this region is of black soil. So this is all you need to remember regarding Usmanabad. Basically, this type of vegetation is there, teak, shrub type, pulses and black soil. Now as they move towards, Solapur region, here what do we find? We find sugarcane cultivation on large proportion. Why? It's due to better irrigation facilities. So from Solapur to Pune region, it is famous for the sugarcane cultivation. Now if you come to the Raigarh and the Alibag region, now there is a catch here. Here we know that evergreen type of vegetation is found. A lot of rainfall is there because of the windward side of the Western Ghats. So here we find betel nut, cashew nut, then we have rice cultivation. A lot of fruits are grown in this region. So this is the type of vegetation that you will come across Usmanabad, then Solapur to Pune, sugarcane, and then Raigad, betelnut, cashew nut, rice, and banana. Now moving to the next point, there are some important points from this chapter that we need to remember. And the first thing we'll talk about it is this one. Here we have Usmanabad. And here we have Solapur. Now while moving from Usmanabad to Solapur, there is one mountain range or hill range which is Balaghat range that you need to remember. Okay, then when you move from Solapur to Pune, you come across this small reservoir called as Ujni Dam. It is located on river Bhima, and they have mentioned that it is a multi-purpose project. What do you understand by multi-purpose project? So आप लोगों को ये समझना होगा, multi-purpose project means initially these dams are constructed for prevention of flood, but later on the water is used for drinking purpose, irrigation purpose, and you know, industries purpose also. Even the local communities they get their livelihood option. That's why they are known as multi-purpose. So here we have Ujni Dam on river Bhima. Then if you come to Pune, we have mentioned just now there is another dam that was there, Khadakwasla Dam on river Mutha. Then Pune to Lonavala, and then Lonavala we move to Khopoli. Now here they have mentioned one important pass in the Western Ghat in this region, and the name of that pass is Borghat. Do remember this. It connects Pune to Mumbai. This is another important point that you need to remember in this region. And then when they move toward this region called as Alibag, we know that they are crossing the Western Ghats. These are some another point that you need to remember. Now when you move toward this Alibag region, here we have one river, West flowing river. We'll talk about it. And the name of that particular river is Ullas River. Ullas River. It is a west flowing river. Now you need to understand this entire region of Maharashtra. You know, it is a fissure type of volcano that was there in this region. That's why we find one of the important rock in this region called as basalt rock, which is also known as in the category of igneous rock. I have posted one video on this same channel. You can remember all types of rocks with the help of tricks, which you can watch this video. Okay, so this is the basalt rock which is there in this particular region, and that's why basalt rock is one of the component why we have black soil in this region. Now this was the main crux of the particular chapter. We'll talk about some question answers. Yes, question answers which can be asked from this particular chapter. Now the first question that we come across is the field visit questionnaire. You don't have to worry about this because they will not ask you the questionnaire for factory. I'm telling you this. Why? This has been done so many times. You need to do questionnaire for visit to a village, factory, research institute, fort. And on this specifically, I have mentioned a video giving all the questions, 10 to 11 questions per topic. I have posted it. You can watch that video. So there is nothing to worry about this. But let me tell you one thing. Field visit is important, and the questionnaires will be asked. One of the question is possible. Now I talk about the importance of field visit. काफी सारे बच्चे इसमें confused होते हैं कि क्या points लिखे sir. तो चलो देखते हैं एक-एक करके आराम से समझेंगे. First point, all of us are quite aware that geography is incomplete without field visit. So it is our important. It is an important method of studying geography. The first point. Okay. Now the second point that you can mention here is fit widget. It also, you know, helps us to understand geographical, cultural and economic conditions of a place. So when we visit, हम जहाँ पे जाते हैं तो हमें समझ में आता है कि geographical conditions कैसे, what is the climate, what is the terrain, water availability, cultural aspects, the food, cuisine and other facts, economic conditions, the main occupations and the types of settlements. Third point, now it gives us an opportunity. जब हम जाते हैं वहां पे we get an opportunity to interact with local people. And this is very important. The main purpose is same. We should visit and we should have interaction with local people. And when we interact with local people, kya samajh mein aata hai? We understand their problem. We understand their problems. Okay, and the last point that you can write here is to understand the correlation between man and nature. So how man has adapted to the environment, that you can measure. So all these 4 points will face 4 marks. So this was the regarding the importance of field visit. Now after doing this, I don't think there is another question from this. There is another question that is there. Yes, how to write field visit report. I have also given the brief outline on one of the video. But here I will share in short how you can write about it. See, you can divide writing a field visit into 3 parts. The first part can be field visit report. So first part can be introduction. You can just give a normal idea that when you are going to visit, what is the name of that particular place, why it is so important. Then main body. Here you need to write the detailed answer, like why it is so important, what steps were taken, uska previous situation kaise tha, baad mein kuch important changes unhone laye honge. And third point is conclusion. So here you can mention like whatever changes they may have done, because of that they may have got many awards, they may have impacted so many lives. So ye teen category mein aap field visit report likh sakte hain. Isi tarah aap ye pura chapter aasani se cover ho jata hai. Baki koi important point is chapter mein mujhe to nahi dikhai deta. So we'll have another chapter and another video, same way we'll revise all the 9 chapters in quick revision video series. So thank you for watching, and please check out some other videos which I have posted regarding this geography of Maharashtra State Board. Thank you.